Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. So in today's video, we are putting head-to-head Dropbox Paper versus Google Docs. Now, for those who want to skip ahead to the certain feature that you want to hear about, you can use the timestamps below and also discover some of the useful functions that both these applications have. So what we'll be doing is sort of going through the applications in general, and then we're going to dive into some of the features that make them really special. So the first application, which is Dropbox Paper, is clearly run by Dropbox. It is an application that has been around for around about 2 or 3 years now, and it's been growing in popularity. Now, for those who don't know, Dropbox is a cloud storage site and essentially works allowing you to store any files or documents there. But the paper service essentially allows you to create new documents or notes within the application. And I would put the likes of Google Docs as a close competitor. Now, Google Docs is an extension of the Google Drive cloud storage service, allowing you to create documents, sheets, and a host more. But in this case, we're just going to be talking about Google Docs. Now, Google Docs has been growing rapidly for maybe 5, 6, 7 years now, and is one big favorite for many due to its collaboration function. So Dropbox Paper, although very new to the space, has been able to add a host of different benefits. Now, going on to Dropbox Paper, you get a home, docs, and folders for organizing your different documents. Now, from Dropbox Paper, you can create any new document. You can even use a host of templates as well, which makes it really useful when it comes to saving time and starting new projects. Now, you can also create a specific meeting note, which can be attached to your calendar, which makes everything a lot easier. Now, if you want, you can import any documents in most of the formats, which is very helpful. And of course, once you've created a document, you can organize them into folders. Now, of course, Dropbox Paper has a search functionality, but one of the big bonuses is that it has this to-do list function, allowing you to select something within your text to do later. So you can actually see per document what you need to get done, or even per date as well, because you can assign due dates to those items too. This is one of the more recent functions inside of Dropbox Paper, and one of the experiences that many people are enjoying. The specific things that people love about Dropbox Paper are the conversational functions on the right-hand side. You can collaborate with other people as well. That's something you can do inside of Google Docs, but people like the ability to add GIFs and emojis and a bit more conversational when you're already using Dropbox. Now, if you want inside of any of the Dropbox Paper documents, you can add videos or images or even GIFs that are more interactive, allowing you to see them in line without any worries. At any given time, you can invite individuals to the Dropbox Paper. You can see the document history, you can word count it, you can even present it, print it, and download it, or add it to a file, star it, or follow it, which allows you pretty much all the access points that you need to get things done. Now, a more recent feature that's been added to Dropbox Paper is allowing you to edit the templates, so you can create your own templates to share with others, almost creating this base. Now, within Dropbox Paper documents, you can add Dropbox files, any multimedia, you can add images, you can also add tables too, to-do lists, as well as bullet points, and many more options like numbered lists, adding break, section breaks, and also code too. Now, many people have rewarded Dropbox Paper with a more interactive experience, allowing users to be a little more spacious with their experience, creating their own workspaces and allowing them to manage projects easier, especially with the likes of the things to do function, as well as the multimedia. And of course, the meeting agendas function is something that does separate it from the likes of Google Docs. So moving on to Google Docs, the experience is very easy to get on with. Many people have regarded this one of the best experiences and probably the most consistent. Now, Google Docs is of course available on iOS and Android. So is the Dropbox Paper as well. However, the experience has been around a little longer on Google Docs. Now, if you want to create your own new brand new document, you can, and of course, organize it in a folder system, which Google Drive allows you to do. But you can use one of the templates as well. So you can actually choose it from a template. They have a host of templates, including the likes of resumes, brochures, and project proposals. Now, many people have regarded Google Docs as the best way to collaborate. You can invite someone to it using an open link. They don't necessarily have to have a Google account too, allowing them to modify the document without any worry, as well as being able to add hundreds of people at any given time. Now, the great thing is you can add the likes of images, tables, and a host of other functions inside of a Google Doc. And they also have an add-ons function allowing you to add a host more. In terms of the visual experience, Google Docs doesn't really scream beauty, but it does have a pretty simplistic design. It's almost like an online version of Word, which it pretty much is, and does allow you to do a host of beneficial things. One of the things that many people like is the sort of like add-on tools that you can have. So you can use a function called Explore to see different items or research items. You can use Dictionary. You can even use your Google Keep notepad in there too to make other notes. You can use voice typing as well, which is a standalone function allowing you to essentially type up something using your voice. There's a host of add-ons as well, so if you've installed them, you can install them through the Google Chrome, Google Docs web store, I think it's called. And using these allows you to add a little bit of tasters. It's almost like apps for your Google Docs. Now, the collaborative functions are really easy to get on with, and many people sort of give a massive head nod to them for progressing this in the space. Now, creating a Google Doc is pretty easy, but one thing I would say is it's pretty bloated in terms of its experience. It's very static, unlike Dropbox Paper, which is a bit more fluid and open and very much a more media-focused experience. Now, in terms of the pricing side of stuff, of course you need for Dropbox Paper access to a Dropbox account. The Dropbox account obviously needs, I think you get 2 gigabytes free. I will add that in description because it's been a long time since I checked that, but you need a Dropbox account to access that. You also need a Google account to access Google Docs as well, but you get a 15 gigabyte drive access, which is very helpful for all accounts, and that's a default experience. So in terms of the storage amounts, Google Docs wins here only slightly, but again, you know, creating documents inside these applications, unless you're adding hideous amounts of media, aren't gonna fill your storage up that fast. So guys, you're probably wondering, who is the winner? What do I use? Now, the winner here, I am not gonna give any awards. I would say Google Docs is a very strong and reliable tool, but I would give the more progressive tool and fluid tool and the one with more potential to Dropbox Paper, especially due to the meeting agenda functions, things to do functions, and much more. But I can see Google Docs having a sort of rebrand or reskin very soon. So you're probably wondering, which one do I use? And it totally depends on what experience you go with. Now, I highly recommend keeping your experience if you are uploading files and documents into the same service. So for example, if you're a Google Drive storer or somebody stores stuff there, then I would use Google Docs. If I was a Dropbox user aggressively, then I would probably use Dropbox Paper. But in this case, what I highly recommend is review what works best for you. What I would say is if you're in a design or more media focused team, Dropbox Paper is gonna work great for you. And I think a lot of people will appreciate it, as well as you as a creative maybe being a bit more open and fluid. But Google Docs is a bit more rigid when you're making proposals and business documents. It does feel a lot better and more professional to some extent. Obviously, all of this might change in the next year, so do keep out for videos here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel for any updates, but there are a ton of other videos if you want to go and enjoy them. Anyway, guys, I hope that you enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think of Dropbox Paper versus Google Docs. Which one have you gone with? Which one are you using now? It'd be great to hear. So guys, you can also claim a 2-month free Skillshare below if you want. It is a resource that allows you to learn loads of new things. So if you want to go deeper with Google Docs, maybe there probably is a course there for it. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below what your thoughts are. It'd be great to hear from you. Without further ado, thank you very much. Make sure you have a great week. Keep productive. See you guys very, very soon. That was very fast. Cheers.